So good morning, everyone, respected jury members, respected faculty, and my fellow student managers. My name is Ayush Bhargav.
And my name is Meet Parekh, and we are from River Saraswati.
So let me first start with a question, which is, how many of you know that which company has launched the first handheld phone?
Yeah, correct. And do you also, anyone has had a flip phone of Motorola? Yes. Thank you.
So our topic for the day is the downfall of Motorola mobility. So as you all know that Motorola has facing really great problems from the year 2007. It has been degrading. So we choose this topic because I've been using Motorola phone for 2 years, and Motorola was the first phone which I used. So that's why we choose this topic. So let's talk about the introduction. So the founder of Motorola was Paul V. Galvin and Joseph E. Galvin. Motorola headquarter is in Schaumburg, Illinois, USA. Company founded on September 25, 1928. Company name was Galvin Manufacturers.
So in 1963, the company became namely as Motorola, as we all know. In 2011, due to the economic problems it faced, it lost $4 billion, and due to which they separated the company in two groups, that is Motorola Solutions and Motorola Mobility. So the topic of presentation is Motorola Mobility. On the August 15, 2011, the Motorola was acquired by the Google for $12.5 billion, and laterwards it was acquired by Lenovo for $2.5 billion. Next slide, please.
So let's talk about the history. So we'll talk about the Motorola history. In 1984, as we have already asked you the question, that the first handheld phone which we can also call as the cordless phone which we use in our houses was launched by Motorola, which was called as Motorola Dynatech. And first company to introduce flip phone was also Motorola, and the name of the phone was Microtech. Motorola split into two different companies due to a loss of $4.3 billion. And it split it into two companies, which were Motorola Mobility and Motorola Solutions. So these were the two companies in which Motorola split. Next slide.
So this is the product range from 1983 till now. So the first phone, as we told, that it was Dynatech. Then the second phone was Microtech in 1989. Then the best selling phone of the Motorola, which was Razr, was in 2004. It continued till 2006, and it was the best selling phone and highest grossing income for the Motorola. And today the Motorola Z3 is launched, and it's going on very well.
Next slide. Now we'll talk about the downfall. What was the actual problem? Why did the downfall happen? And this is the main slide which our topic downfall of Motorola represents. So if we can see that from 1997, we have picked this data from 1997 to 2008. The reason behind this is because if we can see that the Motorola has been is started growing from 1997, and it started growing till 2006. And in 2007 and 2008, it started degrading. Why? What was the reason? Because Motorola was only focusing on one of its phone, that is Razr V3. So it was focusing on Razr V3, which was its flip phone and which became successful. But the problem was that it was not focusing on other phones or other technologies. So this graph predicts that from 2005, if you can see that 2004, 2005, 2006, the sales was growing. But in 2007, because Nokia and other companies took over, therefore the sales was declining. And in 2008, it was also declining. Next slide.
So the reasons of the downfall of the Motorola. So Motorola missed the movement to the 3G. As the world was going towards the upgradation from 2G to 3G, Motorola was not satisfied, was not able to cope up with those changes. So it failed miserably during the 2006. It also appeared outdated, like Motorola V3, that was his famous product, was also continued till long years, and it was not that much of like in design, that much of good in design. And compared to to it, the Nokia and BlackBerry were launching too much of good product in the design, in the graphics, in the screen size as well. The other reason was the company was paying for the mistake of its past, like AT&T, and they were all so small company during those days, and they were also acquiring the customers through the contracts, but the Motorola didn't do all those stuff. So they missed those things which they repaid for it, and that was the reason for the downfall.
We'll also see that the Motorola was running at their own pace. Motorola thought that they were doing a great market. They have launched their Razr phone. They'll do the highest sales in market. But it was not that, because the competitors were there and they didn't realize that. It got defeated by inner politics. What does it mean is that there were 60,000 or more than 60,000 employees in their company, and they were planning and they were plotting against each other. So the company was falling apart at that point of time. Lack of market knowledge. At that time, it seems that they didn't realize that what the market is talking about and what and how the market is being going to handle. Nokia takes the lead. The main reason of the downfall of Motorola is that Nokia take the lead. That Nokia was in so much of form that Motorola didn't realize that it's going downwards, and Nokia has launched so many of their phones that Motorola didn't realize. Next slide.
And also we know the Nokia phones, that memes are going on today because of its strength and durability. Yeah, so it's the competitors' market share during the 2007-8-9. We can see clearly that how in 2007, Motorola was heading for 6.1% of market share, but it decreased gradually from 2007 to 8 to 9. And we can also see that how the Nokia, BlackBerry, Apple and Samsung were gaining the market size during those years.
Next slide, please. Next slide. So the competitors at that time were Samsung, BlackBerry, Sony Ericsson, Apple and Nokia. Next slide.
So this is the current market share of the Motorola. Motorola has revived a little bit from their failures. We can see that today most of us use the Xiaomi. Xiaomi has 29% of the market share. The next one is the Samsung. Samsung has around 23% of the market share. So these both companies take around the 50% of the market share, and Motorola has hardly of 2.8% of the market share. Next slide, please.
Next slide. And now we'll talk about the current market size. So we'll say that the total market size is around 1,70,999 crore. And Xiaomi, as we can see, the revenue share of Xiaomi is 49,689 crore, which in comparison with Motorola is having only 4,797 crore, which is 2.8% of market share in comparison with Samsung, Vivo, Oppo and Realme, which are having a higher market share.
Next slide, please.
Next slide.
So this is the pricing strategy of the Motorola. Moto One Vision, it was around 20,000 rupees, and the competitive pricing strategy was used. And today it is also Moto G6 Plus, which is around 12,000, and it has penetrative type of pricing strategy. So these are the pricing strategy of the Moto models that are launched today. Next slide, please.
So marketing strategy, as we can see that marketing strategy was divided into exclusively available on online shopping portals, because Motorola has not been provided on offline, so it is exclusively available on online portals, tied up with third party company who specialized in customer services, MotoCorp app that can provide online assistance, available at an affordable price as compared to other companies. If we compare it with Vivo, Oppo, the price are almost same, so it is so the model name and the company brand value of Motorola is really high. Exclusive design which attracts the customer, its design, the features it has attracts the customer. Lenovo is selling all its phone under Moto, so the main reason is this also, the marketing strategy that Lenovo is selling all its phone under Moto. Lenovo is not using its name, it's using Moto's name.
So the strength and the weakness, unique design and style. As we know that Moto is known for its design, it's different than other models that are launched. People have trust in brand. We trust. Thank you.